Hi there! In this video, we'll see how we can quickly make a simple timeline from scratch using the data view, where you can easily add and edit project data. When working with Office Timeline, the important thing to remember is that tasks take place between start dates and end dates, while milestones happen on single specific dates. Let's see how that works by making some of them, shall we? In PowerPoint, go to the Office Timeline ribbon. Think of this ribbon as the base of operations for anything related to timelines. To create a new timeline, we'll use the New button up here. Office Timeline gives you the option of using predefined templates, which can help you speed things up significantly. You can find out more about that in the video dedicated to templates. You also have the option of importing data from other project management software through our various integrations. To find out more on this topic, go back to our Learning Center and look for the video series dedicated to importing data for the Office Timeline integrations. For now, let's choose Create Timeline from scratch. This will open a new window that we call the Data View. The main purpose of the Data View is to help you accurately create and change items on your timeline by showing them in a detailed list. The Data View is a powerful tool as it allows you to edit numerous parameters for each task and milestone. But for now, we'll just focus on the most important ones: the title of your item, the type, and the specific dates. Let's practice this on this default task. Change its title, then its start date, and end date. But one lonely task is definitely not enough to make a timeline. So let's add some new items by clicking on the plus icon here. Then use this column here to switch some of them from tasks to milestones by selecting shapes from the milestone side of the window. Now edit their titles and dates, just like we did earlier. I'm going to fast forward through this part to keep this video short, but you can go ahead and edit for as long as you like. There, now we have a bunch of items ready. Eager to see how your timeline looks? Well, for that, we can switch over to the timeline view from up here. Looks nice, right? Speaking of the timeline view, you'll soon find out that it can help you to do so much more than just see your timeline. But we'll cover that in its dedicated video lesson. If you want to go back to editing your data, you can switch between the data view and the timeline view from up here. Once you're satisfied, click on Create and Office Timeline will put your freshly created graphic on a new PowerPoint slide. There, that looks pretty good for something made in just a couple of minutes, right? And if you want to return to editing your data, all you have to do is go to the Office Timeline ribbon and click on Edit Data, which will reopen the data view. It's the easiest way to manage your project data. Now it's your turn. Go back to PowerPoint and make a timeline for yourself. If you need any help, you can always return to this video and use the chapter markers to quickly get to the portion of the video you're interested in. Once you're done, you can move on to the next video of this series to see how you can make your timeline look even better.